Hey guys, it's Alex, and this time I have a little bit of a guide for you. It's going to be how to make mesos. I'm not sure what every server is like, but based off Galicia, I'm just going to assume that this event has sort of killed the economy and made it a little bit harder to make money recently. So this is just a guide that is still true for today. And it'll help you make a little bit of money. So, anyway, the first thing I did was go to Ardent Mill, and if you're an accessory crafter, that's pretty much key for just this way to make money. It's pretty key. So you get accessory crafting, and first thing you need to do is buy some adamantium ores, and then turn them into plates. Each ore costs 10,000, so 100 ores costs you 1 mil, and what I do is I just buy 300 adamantium ores and then make them all into plates. That gives you 100 plates. Then go ahead and buy 100 intermediate abrasives, and you use your accessory crafting to make nimble rings, nimble ring 2. The reason you do this is because to make that ring it only takes one adamantium plate and one intermediate abrasive, and what I like to do with them is after I've made the rings is find somebody's extractor and you break them down. So breaking down a nimble ring leaves you with intermediate item crystals, and you can go ahead and sell those intermediate item crystals for around 100k each, maybe 150k each. So if you do all the math, each ring costs you one adamantium plate and one intermediate abrasive, and that comes out to 35k if you buy everything. And then when you break the rings, you get two or three intermediate crystals, so your 35k turns into at least 200k per ring. So that's a profit of 165k on every ring. So yeah, that's just one way to do it. The next way is to take advantage of the Legend Coin shop. A lot of people like to buy Mystery Mastery books. I don't really like to, but that's definitely one way to do it if they sell fast. What I like to do is buy these legendary maple scarves. They only cost 8 coins, and I sell them for 12 mil each. So in my server, that would be 16 coins for 24 mil if I buy the legendary scarves, or 20 coins for about 20 to 25 mil by selling a Mystery Mastery book. So you can go ahead and change like what your method, whatever you want it to be, based on your server. But that's just how it is for Galley, and it's a pretty decent way to make money. Just it's a little bit harder to get coins now, but if you can get your legend coins, then I definitely recommend taking advantage of the shop. Okay, next way. It's an old way. Everybody knows about it. Most people do it right away. It's the Sibani's Legacy quest in New Leaf City. You go ahead and go into Bigger Ben. It's on the left of New Leaf City. It's a clock tower. And talk to Jack Barricade at the bottom and start his first quest at Sibani's Legacy. And so you have to come in here, which is just the first map right after Jack Barricade, and you have to kill 40 fire tusks, 30 maple eaters, and 50 killabees. And once you do all that, Jack Barricade gives you a 60% glove attacks roll. So right now in Galicia, that's 8 mil, 8 to 10 mil actually if you have a shop. And takes about 10 minutes to do the quest, and so that's easy money. You can do it at level 36 on any new character, and you can only do it once. Okay, so after you do that, you've got your glove attack scroll, you've got whatever you buy from the legend shop. Come to this guy, Elpam Gorlab. He's on the right side of New Leaf City, and you can start his. He's got two quests, and this is a little bit lesser known because most people don't like to do the quest. But first quest, it doesn't really give you a good reward, and what you have to do is just come to either the fire chamber in Bigger Ben or that first map where you do Sibani's Legacy quest, and you have to kill fire tusks and collect 30 LPAM magnets. So you used to have to go to Omega Sector, if people remember doing this quest. But he doesn't make you do that anymore, so it's a lot better. So yeah, you get your 30 LPAM magnets, and then you go ahead and go back to the LPAM Lore Lab guy. And he gives you, I think, 7 little attack potions, some fame, and experience, but he unlocks the second quest. And the second quest is what's really important. Okay, so here we are. We finished the first quest already, got our elixirs, and the second quest reversal right here. If you go ahead and start this quest, it takes a little bit longer to do, because you need to collect 60 of the item from Electrofence. But it's definitely worth it. So go ahead and come to the Ice Chamber. It's in Bigger Ben, down below Wolf Spiders, and then the next map, just so you know how to get there. This is a pretty decent map for Electrofence, or you can go ahead and go to the Krakian Jungle map. On the side of New Leaf City. Most people know where it is if you've done any of these quests before. Anyway, so you just need to kill the Electrofence. I believe this quest is a level 40 quest. And you need to pick up all your temporal fragments from Electrofence. And then once you do all that, you go back to Elfam Gore Lab again in NLC. And you talk to him, and he gives you a 70% glove attack scroll. So, it's really good. Yeah, I think it's maybe 10 to 12 mil right now in Galicia. And it'll be different for your server. But anyway, it's a little bit harder to make money now, but these ways still work. So, it took me about an hour to do all these quests and to make the rings and everything. And I ended up with 60% glove attack scroll, 70% glove attack scroll, 2 legendary maple scarves, but I got those coins at a different time, so can't really count that. And then I got 80 intermediate monster crystals, but I still have a bunch of adamantium plates, so add that up, and I'll put the total on the screen because I'm running out of time for the video. But so it takes an hour, and it's not really that hard at all, and you can go ahead and make some money that way. So thumbs up the video if you like the guide, and thanks for watching.